Good evening and welcome to Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. Arizona's historic first ever recall election for a state legislator is 1 week away. On November 8th, voters of Mesa's Legislative District 18 will decide if they want to keep Senate President Russell Pearce in office or if they want to replace him with challenger Jerry Lewis. I spoke with both candidates last week. Tonight, we bring you those interviews, starting with Jerry Lewis. Thank you for joining us tonight on Horizon.
Thank you for having me.
Why are you running? Why are you doing this?
I'm doing this because some great people who I've known for 30 years asked me to enter this race, a race that I had thought about for about 5 years as I've watched what's happened to the image of Mesa, the image of Arizona, and felt that something needs to be done to change the tone in the political scene and bring back a fresh voice to Mesa. And so when they asked me, I thought about it for 5 years, but never really serious. Didn't want to be a politician, but we felt that we needed to do so.
Was there one incident that pushed you to run?
I think no incidents in general, but it's just, like I say, 3 or 4 years of just seeing the same thing and seeing our economy continue to tumble, seeing the lack of representation that the voters wanted, and sitting on the sidelines just saying, someone's got to do something, someone's got to stand up and run. And when my schedule freed up a little bit, that became me.
Talk to us about the lack of representation that the voters wanted. Give us an example of something that Senator Pearce has done that the voters, you think, didn't necessarily want being done.
Well, I think the ignoring of the other key issues, education, the economy, while focusing on other immigration issues, and other things that were totally outside of the realm of Arizona and the city of Mesa. I think people saw that and said, hey, you know, we're still here. We're the ones who put you in office, so we'd like you to pay attention to what our concerns and our needs are.
And you thought that reached a level that deserved basically a do-over on the Russell Pearce election?
In terms of the recall or the election itself?
Well, in terms of, it's a do-over as far as Russell Pearce is concerned. He was voted in, and you're saying this has reached a point to where you need to vote on this again?
Yes, I believe, along with many other citizens of Mesa, that we need to have a better representation. We need to have a more civil tone brought back to the political scene in the state and in our city.
Let's talk about a variety of issues. We'll start with SB 1070. That's a major issue as far as your opponent's concerned and something as major as far as the race is concerned. You initially said you thought SB 1070 was a good start in terms of immigration mm-hmm. reform and enforcement. Do you still feel that way?
What I meant by that comment is that it is a piece of the overall picture that has to be addressed. We can solve this issue in a way that we can all be happy with and proud of. There's a whole lot more than just the rule of law, which is vitally important to this discussion. We have to consider national security. We have to consider what our current existing immigration laws do to splitting up families. We have to look at the economic impact, the impact on schools, on our healthcare facilities, on our welfare systems. Most of all, we have to look at what is the federal government's role in this, and we can't continue to let the federal government be abdicated from their responsibility. I believe we have an issue here of securing the border we have to address. We have 12 and a half million people in this country that are undocumented. We have to find a way to do so, and I believe there's great solutions out there. We just need to create an environment where those solutions can be debated in a civil tone and implemented.
So would you have voted for SB 1070?
That's a hypothetical question, and I think I wasn't there, so it'd be hard for me to answer that. But I would like to think that if I was part of that, I would have been looking for a complete solution rather than just one aspect of it, and would have been spending a whole lot more time, I think, trying to figure out ways to get the federal government to perform their duties.
Your opponent has pushed for proof of citizenship in order to register to vote, to push for proof of eligibility for public benefits, a variety of immigration-oriented goals and plans and laws, and he's pushed these, many of these, through the legislature. Again, is that something that is wrong? Is that malfeasance? Why should he be voted on again after doing these particular things?
It's not malfeasance. However, I think it's focusing on those issues while other issues that are very important to Mesa voters are left to dwindle. And I think people were tired of it. People want to change. I've not met anybody that doesn't want to secure the border or that doesn't want to have a real reform package in immigration that will work. Okay, the problem is the environment that exists today is if you come up with any sensible or reasonable solution, you're called a traitor or an open border radical, and that's not the case. People want reform, but they want reform that will work, that will not be debated in the course of the next 5 or 10 years.
Real quickly, you said that in a debate, Arizona was akin to 1964 Alabama. What did you mean by that?
Okay, what I said was people outside of Arizona look at us as if we are akin to 1964 Alabama. I did not say that myself.
Sure, but what did you mean by that?
What I meant is that from the people that I've spoken to, both in and out of the state, in and out of the country, they're looking at us and saying, wow, you guys are really mean people there. You're really tough on those people from the outside. You look kind of like Alabama did back in the 1960s. Now, thankfully, Alabama's changed a great deal, and no disparagement on Alabama or definitely on my city or my state. I love Mesa. I love Arizona, okay? I'm just saying people outside don't see us as we see ourselves and as we truly are. I'm very proud to be a Mesa resident and a resident of this great state.
Your opponent says he promised and delivered a truly balanced budget. He led the way on this, and he says it is truly balanced. Some disagree with him on the truly part, but he says he did it. Do you agree with him?
Did the debits equal the credits? I suppose they do. And from my accounting background, I can probably say that part, yeah, has. But, you know, the idea of no gimmicks, when you have to sell your capital and lease it back, I mean, is that a gimmick? Maybe it is. If you have to push all of those unfunded mandates onto the cities and counties, is that a gimmick? I think we have to look at the whole state. Is the whole state, in a balanced budget? And I think we need to look at the whole state and make sure that we're all understanding what the balanced budget really means.
So again, I'm going to ask you this again in a different form. Would you have voted for those budgets if you were in the legislature?
I'd like to think we could have gone to the educational institutions who we had to cut. I mean, everybody understands. No one's wanting a free lunch here. Okay, and I would like to have thought that we would have consulted with the larger school districts and other charter organizations to say, hey, we got to cut you. Where would you like to be cut? Where would be the least painful for you? Rather than saying, we're going to cut you here, we're going to cut you there. And in talking with school officials and city officials, that's all they want. They want to be listened to. They want to be understood. And business people just the same. They want to know that their voice counts, and when they tell you something, they're not just saying it for some kind of a political favor or whatever. They really mean what they say, and they want to have a voice in the political process.
As far as cuts to the state Medicaid program, cuts to access, eligibility freeze, those sorts of things. Again, pushed through the legislature, signed by the governor, your opponent, a major factor in these laws mm-hmm. and in this legislation. How do you feel about
that? Okay, we have to look at all revenue, all expenses, and determine what extent do we want to be involved with as a government? What role should government play in any aspect that we're currently funding? We have to then prioritize those particular items that we deem appropriate for government to be involved with. Okay, and if education and Medicare are those items which we feel are the most important, and that's what the voters agree with, okay, we need to figure out ways to implement that which is affordable. We can't continue to go into debt to fund programs that we can't afford.
The mayor of Mesa is very outspoken on the legislature meddling in municipal affairs. And again, your opponent has helped push through legislation that does just that, according to a lot of municipal leaders. How do you feel about the state telling cities, like on impact fees, for example, mm-hmm. and other aspects of municipal life and governance? What do you feel about the state pushing its will in that direction?
Well, it's interesting. I just had a meeting with one of the city councilmen this morning, and it's interesting. He said, you're the first person from the state to come and actually ask me, what can we do as a state to help you as a city? He says, what a novel idea. And I've done that with several other council members and other business leaders and education leaders as well. I think all they're asking for is, can we have a voice in what you're thinking? Okay, if you're gonna push something on us, would you please listen to what we have to say? Would you please discuss with us first? And that's what I hope to do with my experience in leadership, education, accounting, and so forth, business background. You got to listen to people, and you got to take what they say to heart and act thereon.
Your opponent has passed jobs bills. He's passed pro-life bills, mm-hmm. gun laws, parental choice in education, mm-hmm. been a forefront there. On any of those issues, do you differ from him significantly?
No. No.
If you don't, then are you different from Russell Pearce simply because you're not Russell Pearce?
No, that would be an easy assumption to make, and that's certainly not the case. I believe with my experience in the real world, with business, education, accounting, okay, and leadership experiences, I bring a tone of leadership that really wants to solve problems, and I don't care who gets the credit for it. I really believe that we need to focus on what the voters want, okay, and listen to what they have to say. They're the ones that put us in office. They expect us to legislate in their behalf, in their best interests, in this great republic we have. And so what I bring is someone that will listen and has listened to employees, to people on various sides of issues, to solve problems, tough problems that you just can't soundbite away. You have to dig into the details and have to fully understand it and make sure that people are represented in that discussion.
And people represented in Mesa want to know that whoever is representing them has enough wherewithal, power, clout, whatever you want to talk about. Yeah. There. He is the president of the Senate. He has a lot of power at the legislature. Some call him the de facto governor, if you will. Why should Mesa voters decide that you would be better in that position, at least representing them, than him?
I think several reasons. There's a whole lot more support at the Capitol than I think people are aware of. And a lot of people, they are silently supporting in very, very many ways, through emails, through talking with friends and so forth. I've spoken with a lot of legislators who are definitely supporting me, and they said, don't worry, you hear that from some of the people. That's not the case. You will fit in here, and you're not going to be a pariah, as I've been called, in the Republican Party. You will fit in here, and we'll be able to work together to move forward on those issues which are important to Mesa and to Arizona at this time.
Last question. Your critics say you're being used by the open border and amnesty crowd. You're being used by Democrats. You're being used by union proponents, all sorts of folks that are not necessarily from Mesa, not necessarily from your district. You're being used to get at Russell Pearce. How do you respond?
Absolutely not true. It's interesting. You look at my support in this election. 68% of it has come right from Mesa, and we've already filed our support. We filed it, our candidates' report. We filed it the day after it was due. People that support me are from Mesa. Okay, I've never met Randy Perez. I don't plan on it. I've never met Chad Snow. I don't plan on it. I'm nobody's puppet. I've been accused of a lot of these things. I ran because it's something that I felt deeply for some time, and good people asked me to run. I considered it, prayed a lot about it, and made a decision, and here I am.
All right. Good to have you on the show. Thank you for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.